On January 1st, 1801, Giuseppe Piazzi discovered the first dwarf planet, Ceres. The search for Ceres had been sparked by Johann Elert Bode, who had predicted that planetary orbits occurred at regular intervals, so there must be a planet between Mars and Jupiter. The regular intervals idea is flawed, Neptune for instance is out of place, but it did successfully lead to the discovery of Ceres. Bode and fellow astronomers had planned to form a search party for the missing planet, called the Celestial Police, when one of their intended members, Piazzi, found Ceres in the predicted location. Piazzi had already established a name for himself in astronomer circles for cataloging stars, and had at first thought that Ceres was another star, until he noticed it was moving too quickly with respect to the other stars in the background. Astronomers have been limited to looking at the tiny speck through ground-based telescopes until the launch of the Hubble Space Telescope, which revealed a roundish world quite unlike the lumpy rocks that otherwise populated the asteroid belt. Ceres, along with smaller asteroid belt inhabitant Vesta, became the target of the Dawn spacecraft mission launched on September 27, 2007. The mission was launched on a Delta II 7925H rocket from Cape Canaveral. The rocket featured 9 solid rocket boosters, 6 lit on the ground and 3 after the first 6 were expended, surrounding a core stage developed from the Thor rockets of the 1960s and topped by the eponymous Delta Upper Stage. The Delta stage would put the probe into orbit, after which it would spin-stabilize the Dawn probe and a payload assist module. The payload assist module, or PAM, was another solid rocket motor which would provide the energy needed to reach Mars, and the gravity assist from Mars propelled Dawn into the asteroid belt. Despite being a relatively light 1.2-ton probe, Dawn had the ability to make orbit around both Vesta and Ceres for long-term observation thanks to its 3 ion engines. These provided a delta V of more than 10,000 meters per second, meaning that Dawn had more ability to affect its trajectory than any probe before it. The results around Ceres were a remarkable view of the largest denizen of the asteroid belt, with a resolution hundreds of times better than that provided by the Hubble Space Telescope. Scientists noted certain bright spots on the surface, which have turned out to be crystallized brine with sodium carbonate and either ammonium chloride or ammonium bicarbonate. The spots may be evidence that Ceres is still somewhat geologically active or volcanic. The dwarf planet may also be able to provide resources for exploration of the outer planets. The success of the Dawn mission in bringing into sharper focus the original discovery of Piazzi 214 years before the probe's arrival is even more striking because the mission was repeatedly cancelled by NASA and only went ahead because Dawn's manufacturer, Orbital Sciences Corporation, said it wouldn't take a profit on the project and built it at cost. Thank you for watching Today in Space History for January 1st.